Take us back to when you first were realizing that something was wrong. Give me an example of how you knew that things weren't right.
What happened was that the fifth and fourth fingers on my right hand began to curl under involuntarily and uncontrollably. From just a slight curling under, it took, as I say, pretty much a full 10 months before they just became locked into the palm of my hand.
And you literally could not reach, play the notes?
I could force them out with great, great effort, but they certainly wouldn't go up and down the way they have to go when you play a piano.
It sounds sort of obvious, but a pianist needs every finger, right?
You might think so. But believe it or not, there is a certain literature, a certain amount of music that is written for left hand alone. And that's thanks to an Austrian pianist who was born before World War I, who found himself a soldier in World War I, and unfortunately had his right arm shot off. He was from a very well-to-do, very wealthy family. His name was Paul Wittgenstein. His home when he was a child was one of the great salons in Vienna. And people like Brahms and Mahler and Strauss and all the great artists and painters and writers of the day would come to Sunday afternoons at the Wittgenstein mansion, as it were.
Mm-hmm.
Being well off, Paul also probably being obsessive compulsive, insisted that he continue to play the piano with, even if only with one hand. Thank goodness the music that has been written for one hand is for left hand. That was the hand that he had. Biomechanically, it does not work to play the piano with the right hand because these fingers take care of the harmony and the rhythm, and you can tap out the melody with the thumb.
Left hand can do it alone.
Yes. Right hand cannot.